Hi friends, in this video we will be dealing with the multiplication of a vector by a real number. Just imagine A is a vector quantity. Okay, A is a vector quantity. If you are multiplying with a real number, say it as the real number we are considering it as lambda. Okay, lambda is a real number. So if you multiply with the vector A, we will be getting a new vector that is equal to lambda times a vector. Here lambda is what? A real number. Now you just imagine if lambda is positive, what will happen? The lambda a vector will be in the same direction of the given a vector. If lambda is negative, what may happen? The lambda a vector become in the opposite direction of the given vector A. Just imagine this is the A vector. Okay, this is an A vector. You multiply this A vector with a real number. Definitely we can say that word. We will be getting a new vector. So I can write here B vector is equal to, you are going to multiply with 2 times the given vector A vector. So how you can represent this in terms of vector notation? We can represent here 2 times the vector A. 2 times the vector A. You see this one? This is a A vector. Now it become what? 2 times A vector. Now you just imagine you are going to multiply with the minus 2. The real number is minus 2. Again we will be getting a new vector that is equal to B vector. But the equation become what? B vector is equal to minus 2 times the A vector. So in this case, how you can represent the new vector? The new vector, you can draw the same magnitude of 2A vector, but the direction become what? Opposite to that of the given vector A vector. So here it become what? 2A vector, that is minus 2A vector. Depends upon the real number. If it is a real number is positive, the direction of new vector in the direction of the given vector. If the real number is negative, the direction become opposite to that of the given vector. Okay, now you just imagine you are going to multiply the given vector A vector with a zero. We will be getting a vector whose magnitude is zero and whose direction is arbitrary. Okay, and this type of vector is called what? Null vector. That means we have a vector A, that is A vector is having a direction. If you are multiplying with a zero, what will happen? The magnitude become zero, but it is having the direction in the same direction of the given vector A vector. So what we are getting it as, we can represent like this, and this is called null vector, or also we can say that it is called zero vector. Okay, so null vector or zero vector. Now let's discuss in detail what is meant by null vector or zero vector. So what is meant by zero vector or null vector? A zero vector or null vector which has zero magnitude. So we can write down the point here, what? A zero vector or a null vector whose magnitude is equal to zero and it is having a direction. What is the direction? It's a direction as the same as the given vector, and we are representing it as what? Zero vector. You see this one? This is a representation of zero vector or null vector. Just an example, if mu is equal to minus lambda, okay, mu is equal to minus lambda, then lambda plus mu into a vector is equal to, we will be getting zero magnitude. That is zero magnitude, but it is having a direction, is in the same direction of the given vector A. So we can note it down, what? Zero vector. This is a representation of what? Zero vector or null vector. Now you just imagine another example. Going to add two vectors, vector A plus vector B. Okay, you are going to add two vectors, vector A and vector B. if b is equal to, vector b is equal to minus a vector, vector b is equal to minus a vector, then what is this value become? A vector plus b vector is equal to null vector, is equal to null vector. So this is all the example for what? Null vector or zero vector. Just discuss about one simple example. Just imagine an object is now traveling, say it as a car. If this car is now traveling with a constant velocity, what is the velocity here? Velocity vector, right? Velocity is constant. If so, what is the acceleration of the car? If the velocity is constant each and every time, we can say here v minus u divided by t, right? Here v as well as u is same, so we can write here acceleration is equal to 0 meter per second square towards the right side. So this case we can consider the acceleration of the car when it is traveling with a constant velocity as what? A null vector or a zero vector. There are a few more examples are there. That is, the velocity vector of a stationary body is a zero vector. The displacement of a ball thrown up and received back by the thrower is a zero vector. One more example, the displacement of a stationary particle from the time t to another time t dash is a zero or a null vector. So these are the few examples for null vector. Now let's discuss about few properties. When you are adding a vector with null vector, you will be getting a vector. Another property, if you are subtracting a null vector or a zero vector from a given vector, once again you will be getting the given vector. Third property, when zero vector is multiplied by a non-zero scalar quantity, example, mu is a non-zero scalar quantity, okay? If you are multiplying with a null vector, you will be getting once again the null vector. The magnitude is equal to zero but having a direction. Next to property, when you are multiplying any vector, say it as a vector, with zero multiplied with zero, what we are getting here? We will be getting once again a null vector. Magnitude is equal to zero. Once again, the direction will be same as what? The given vector, a vector. So these are the properties of the null vector. Okay. Now let's discuss about the subtraction of vectors. So mainly the subtraction of the vectors we are mainly using in connection with the velocities and acceleration. So the process of subtracting one quantity from another quantity is equivalent to what? Adding the negative of the quantity. Example, A minus B can be written as A plus minus B. In the same manner, we can also subtract the vector quantity. Simple example, just imagine A vector minus B vector. You are going to subtract the two vectors. It can be written also like this. How? A vector plus minus B vector. So that means you are adding one vector with a negative of another vector. It's an example. Consider we are given there are two vectors. Say it as this is a vector A and say it as this is the vector B. So as we already learned, using triangle law or parallelogram law of vector addition, we can calculate the resultant. So if you are using the parallelogram law, how you can construct these two vectors? I can shift this vector A like this without change the direction, A vector. Now we can shift the B vector in such a way that both are in contact with the tail to tail. So this is the B vector. If you construct this parallelogram and if you find the resultant, you will be getting the resultant is equal to what? A plus B. But what we require here, subtraction of two vectors. So what you are doing here, the b vector, what you are doing here, the b vector, you are changing the direction of b vector without changing the magnitude. Without changing the magnitude, we're just changing the direction opposite to that of the given vector b. So what will happen here? Now the b vector become what? Negative of b vector. Now you construct the parallelogram. Just construct the parallelogram. If you construct the parallelogram, you will be getting the resultant as a diagonal. You can see this is a resultant. You consider it as r vector. What is r vector? If you use the parallelogram method or the triangle method of vector addition, this is become a vector. Now this is same as minus b vector, right? So what is the formula for resultant vector? R vector is equal to a vector plus minus of b vector. A vector plus minus of b vector. This is same as a vector minus b vector. A vector minus b vector. So this is a way to do what? The subtraction of two vectors.